three words I would use to describe the BUKC would be fast.
Fast-paced.
Exhilarating.
Chaotic.
Competitive.
Family.
Dangerous.
Fun.
Orgasmic.
So I started out in racing when I was 8.
My 10th birthday, I said I wanted to go indoor karting.
My racing career started when I was 13.
I started when I came to uni.
So I did cadet for a year, just club racing, and then went into Super Ones and Stars of Tomorrow, which has ceased now, but it's a series that was about then.
I did a couple of outside races, and they were in pro karts. I did that for a year, and then I finally got into the BUKC team. The
British Pro Kart Endurance Championship, half a season. Then moved on to what's called the Elite Karting League, joined a team from Bristol, who became like my motorsport family. Still very, very close with those guys. Karting more or less takes over your entire life from the second you adopt it as a hobby. From when I've been 13, every spare tenner I've got, every little bit of money that I've earned extra has gone towards funding my racing, because it's what I love doing.
So, finance of the year, we were promised as a university that we'd get 50% subsidisation with sport.
Things took a turn for the worst.
We came into an issue with budget cuts.
So therefore, basically I had to stop racing for the B team this season, just because I can't afford it, quite simply. So hopefully we'll take that up again next season if funding comes back.
You arrive at the racetrack on Friday, you start to smell the two-stroke, the engine's going around the track, and you instantly just get that feeling, it hits you like it's a race weekend.
It's a complete next level.
Shitting myself is the word I use, it's probably the closest I can get.
It's the speed, it's the way it handles, it's everything about it. It'll pick up a lot quicker, it's got a quicker top end, it handles a lot better.
Trying to keep yourself calm, trying not to feel like you're going to be hit off.
So I put my foot down the Club 100, there's great GoPro footage of it. It's 3 years old now, but you can actually hear me go, oh, fucking hell!
Oh, fucking hell!
Once the engines start up and you're coming up to the line and you see the light go green,
there's no sense of excitement like it, because anything can happen in that 25-minute sprint. You could get taken off, you could finish last, you could perform poorly, or you could win.
Oh, without a doubt, there is a danger aspect. It's going into the first corner, the amount of load and the amount of people complaining about whiplash. Just going into the first corner, you can watch videos and everyone's heads are like nodding backwards and forwards.
I caught a bump and I went airborne and I came out the kart seat, kind of flat in the air, and then as the kart nosedived the track and landed, I came with the base of my back onto the back of the kart seat.
Someone had run wide on the grass. It had been quite frosty the night before, so the grass is a bit wet and dewy.
And just heard a click and found myself like clinging to the rear bumper as I hit the wall and sort of was at the edge of the track, and I was concerned, I was winded so I couldn't breathe.
I went into the air doing a full 360 in the kart and landing it. I don't know what happened, but I ended up 90 degrees.
And the medics came running up and I realised I couldn't feel anything below the waist.
On impact, I broke a rib.
So it was about 2 hours later, I'd been in an MRI scanner, I think, and at that point I started being able to feel my legs, and they worded it best they could, translating into English, is basically a dead leg. You can do that to your main spinal nerve. It was the first time I'd fully appreciated there was any kind of concept of seriously injuring yourself doing this at karting level.
That being said, it's a huge social thing to do. You meet up with your buddies that you don't see at all. I mean, we race other unis up and down the country, and then you become friends with them, and then you meet them at every round.
There is no better feeling than having a good result and then having a group of mates to get out the kart and celebrate that with afterwards.
You really do develop a friendship with other teams, and even just your own teammates, you make a special bond with them, or with you racing with them.
If you get injured, yeah, you'll have 3 or 4 weeks out, but by the end of those 4 weeks and you're healed again, you'll be like, get me in a kart next week, done.
once the engines start up and you're coming up to the line and you see the light go green, you stop worrying about anything and it's just a sort of adrenaline rush.
But it's not just about the racing, it's about meeting people. It's what I mean by family. You're always with and around people who you want to be with and having a good time. There's something inside you. It's hard to explain. They're talking.